Hello everyone, I'm Anna Tomskova and welcome to the Algebraic Calculus course. In today's video we will see how to find the modular sine slice area of a circle polynumber curve gamma 3. The first component of its parameterization is the cosine polynumber c6 and the second component is the sine polynumber s7. The graph of this curve looks like this. And you can see that this part of this graph is very similar to the unit circle. Therefore, finding the sine slice area of this curve will help us later to approximate the sine slice area of the unit circle. Let me remind you some modular notations for this video. If P and Q are tuple numbers such that alpha 8 divides the difference P minus Q, then we say that P is congruent to Q modulo alpha to the 8. This is in the case when P and Q are polynumbers of one variable. If P and Q are polynumbers of two variables, and if the difference P minus Q has all terms of degree 8 or more, it means that the sum of powers of alpha and beta in each term of this difference is not less than 8. Then, in this case, we say that P is congruent to Q mod d8. The first part of this problem is to show that the sum of squares of the cosine polynumber c6 and the sine polynumber s7 is congruent to 1 modulo alpha to the 8. Let me remind this expression as follows: cosine times cosine plus sine times sine polynumber. And you can see that this expression is congruent to this expression modulo alpha to the 8. It means that here I write only the alphas with power less than 8. And one can see if we gather all terms with the same alphas here, then this expression is congruent to 1 modulo alpha to the 8. The next part of the problem is to show that the area differential of the curve gamma 3 is congruent to 1 modulo alpha to the 8. Let me remind you that if the parameterization of gamma is pq, then the area differential can be calculated by this formula: p times the derivative of q minus q times the derivative of p. In our case, gamma 3 has this parameterization, therefore the area differential in our case can be calculated as follows: c6 times the derivative of s7 minus s7 times the derivative of c6. And now remember that the derivative of S7 is C6 and the derivative of C6 is minus S5. Therefore, the area differential is this one. Now, C6 times C6 is C6 squared plus here we have two minuses, therefore we have plus here. And you can check that S7 times S5 is congruent to S7 squared modulo alpha to the 8. Therefore, the whole expression is congruent to C6 squared plus S7 squared modulo alpha to the 8. And from the previous part of this problem, we see that this expression is the same as 1 modulo alpha to the 8. Before we proceed, let me prove one simple property of the Faulhaber integral. If we find the integral from T to U of polynumber mod alpha to the 8, then this is congruent to the integral from T to U of this polynumber mod d9. Indeed, if we write this polynumber as follows, this is polynumber plus some alphas with powers not less than 8. And if we try to use the linearity property of the integral, we'll get the following. This is integral of the polynumber p plus some coefficient, the integral of alpha to the 8, plus some coefficient, the integral of alpha to the 9, plus and so on. The powers of alphas here are larger than 9, of course. Okay, and next, this is equal to the integral of the polynumber p, plus maybe some new coefficient, u to the 9 minus t to the 9, plus new coefficient, u to the 10 minus t to the 10, and so on. And the powers of u and t here are larger than 10. And this is congruent, by definition, this is congruent to the integral of the polynumber p mod d9. In this part of the problem, we need to find the sine area from t to u of the curve gamma 3 mod d8. By the fundamental theorem, the sine area of gamma 3 is the same as a half of the integral from t to u of the area differential of gamma 3. From the previous part of the problem, we know that the area differential is 1 mod alpha to the 8. From the property of the Faulhaber integral, we know that this is the same as the integral of 1 mod d9. Now we integrate 1, we get alpha, and this is the same as the difference u minus d. And here we can write mod d8, since we don't have any 8th power of u and t here. In this part of the video, we need to find the sine area of the oriented edge AB, where A is the point gamma 3 of t and B is gamma 3 of u. That is, A has the following form and B is the following. And the sine area of the oriented edge AB is a half of the product this times this minus the product this times this, which is written here. Now we open the brackets, and this expression is the same as this long expression, mod da. It means that we ignore all powers of 8 and more. Now one can see that this can be reduced to this compact expression. U minus t is written here. And the terms with power 3 can be gathered in this bracket, u minus t to the power 3. The same for the power 5 and power 7. Finally, we need to find the slice sine area of the curve gamma 3, mod d8. By definition, this slice sine area is the sine area of this curve plus sine area of the oriented edge BA, where A is gamma 3 of t and B is gamma 3 of u. Or this is the same as minus sine area of the oriented edge AB. From the third part of the problem, we know that the sine area is a half of difference u minus t mod d8, and from the previous part of the problem we know that the sine area of AB is this expression, and everything is mod d8. And you can see that these two terms can be cancelled, and so finally we get the formula that sine slice area of gamma 3 is a half of 1 over 3 factorial u minus t cubed minus 1 over 5 factorial u minus t to the power 5 plus 1 over 7 factorial u minus t to the power 7, and everything is mod d8. This is all for this video. I'm Anna Tomskova. Thanks for listening.